7 out of 10 dogs suffer of animal violence, and every 60 seconds an animal gets abused. Shocking, right? That's the awful truth of what happens to the fauna around the world. Animal neglect has really high numbers, so surprising that it's in a period of a minute, which means 3,600 animals are neglected in an hour. This is the alarming truth our society faces day to day. But we're doing anything to stop it. First of all, what is animal cruelty? In small words, animal abuse is every way of abuse, such as pain, fear, or desperation towards animals. Let's start with something that happened to me a year ago. I was in a small town with my family when a herd dog appeared in front of me. It was so shocking that I had an awful feeling in my tummy and the intense sensation of starting to cry. The doggy was really injured, and I saw the pain it was in. Eventually, I said, "Poor dog, he's really hurt and he's alone." I was thinking, how can people watch this sweet dog and ignore his pain? Then, I heard these words. "Yes, poor dog, but you're used to it anyways." How can that be possible? I realized how selfish humans can be. We saw the dog and ignored the dog, with the possibility it will die. And still, we didn't do anything. I am almost sure you have already had a similar experience with animals, or you'll have it eventually. This is so common that has become part of our daily life. But it is really frustrating that we're doing something about it. There are different types of animal cruelty, which I'm going to explain them for you. If you start to identify them, you will prevent this type of cruelty in the future and do your part in making a difference. Animal abuse. Most cases of animal abuse involve the harming of an animal. For example, when a man kicks a dog for having an accident in the house, or when a woman whips her horse for failing to respond to a comment. Animal neglect. This type of cruelty is based in the simple stage, where a person owns an animal as a pet, but doesn't know how to take care of it. It can even be caused by lack of interest, meaning that the owners ignore injuries, vaccines, diet, etc., with the excuse of saving money. Animal exploitation. These people believe that they have the right to use animals in any way they wish, usually for money making. For example, zoos or pet shops, where the conditions aren't correct for some species, or they are mistreated. Another example are circus and amusement parks, with animals that are used in shows. So, how do we prevent this? Inform yourself. Knowledge is the key to solve problems. Here are some tips. 1. Be a responsible pet owner. 2. Be kind to animals. If you see abandoned animals, take them to a safe shelter. 3. Take action if you see animal cruelty happening. Do what you can, but do something. 4. Report any type of animal abuse, neglect, or exploitation to local authorities. 5. Spread the message with your community. Now that social media makes this easier. Let your family and friends know about animal abuse and how to prevent it. 6. Demand laws that protect the animals. And 7. Shelter an animal who needs it. This can be difficult for a number of reasons, but if you do, you can transform the life of a living being, making a real difference. To recap, even a small action can help make the change. Stopping part of animal exploitation by visiting zoos or shopping in pet shops. Report any type of abuse, etc. You can always search more information to make a bigger transformation. We have the power to make the difference in this horrifying cycle that animals are going through. Remember, animals feel too. They don't only help us keep balance in nature, but also make our lives a lot happier. I'm Domenica Salinas. Thank you for listening to my TED Talk.